Welcome to the Medical Device Made Easy podcast. Here is Munir Lazouzi from easymedicaldevice.com. And today, we wanted to help you understand why maybe an importer and a distributor also need to get certified for ISO 13485 or for the scope in terms of MDR. And for that, I have with me Cristina Miroescu from Sofmedica Group. So Cristina, welcome to the Medical Device Made Easy podcast.
Hello, Monir, and thank you very much for having me at your podcast again.
Exactly.
Among great experts of the industry, I'm really honored, and thank you.
So great. So thank you for you too for being here and give us your if I can say, experience or share with us your experience in terms of certification. Because as I've told you, as I've told Melody, Sofmedica Group is an importer distributor, and you recently got certified, and I wanted you to share your experience about it. But before that, please, can you just make a small introduction of yourself so that the people understand who you are exactly?
Of course. I'm compliance director of Sofmedica Group. I'm here at Sofmedica since 2000, so almost 22 years. A lot of time.
Exactly.
I had different roles during these years, starting with registration of drugs, pharmaceuticals, back in 2020. Then I was also warehouse manager, then quality manager, and lately compliance director. Under the compliance umbrella, we are managing also quality, regulatory, and compliance activities.
Exactly. And just as a reminder, so Cristina and some people of her team also participated to the Green Belt certification program that I'm providing. And I hope this was also something that helped you, if I can say, to get this certification. But
indeed.
Sorry.
Great program.
Yeah, so I hope the people also that were participating to this training were also able to answer auditors and then help you for this. So mainly, let's dig to the topic because as we said, so you are importer distributor. It's not obvious, if I can say, for some importer distributors to be certified under a quality management system and to have this kind of thing. So what was what was the company maybe a strategy for being certified under ISO 13485? Was it like a company strategy or was it like mandatory for you? Or what was exactly your situation in mind?
Well, it's a long discussion and we'll try to discuss about the essence in a few minutes. So why we need an ISO 13485 certification at Sofmedica? Well, during our MDR compliance readiness project, we realized that compliance with ISO 13485 can help us to comply with MDR 2 as they are very similar. So as we all know, ISO 13485 is a harmonized standard now under MDR. And the voluntary application of harmonized standards gives the presumption of compliance with legal provisions in force applicable for the product. So if we have looked in the past when we start our preparation at Article 8 of MDR, use of harmonized standards, which indicates that system or process requirements to be fulfilled by economic operators, such as requirements for quality management system, are to be presumed to be fulfilled if the system or process is in compliance with relevant harmonized standards.
Exactly.
And ISO 13485 is a standard applicable for the entire life cycle of medical device, from design to production, including also distribution, service, testing, subsequent activities, calibration, sterilization, raw material manufacturing, and many others. ISO 13485 specifies also the requirements for quality management system that enable an organization to demonstrate its ability to supply compliant medical devices and related services that meet customer needs and comply, of course, with applicable regulatory requirements. And if we look at Article 10 of MDR, which stipulates a few aspects of quality management system, we can easily see that this is ISO 13485, the majority of ISO 13485 quality management system requirements. A strategy for regulatory compliance, management, and many others.
So, if we say, always we hear that standards like ISO 13485, they are voluntary. But to be honest, I mean, a notified body or a certification body, if you are not ISO, if you are not applied for ISO 13485, they will have some kind of problem because they will have then to dig more on everything that you are doing to show that you are complying to the regulations, if I can say. So to make your life easier and to make also the life of the auditors easier, following ISO 13485 is your best chance to be then compliant immediately. Because as you've said, as soon as you are following an harmonized standard, you are supposed to be compliant to the regulation. So then there is no question about that.
More than that, Sofmedica, as an importer and distributor of medical devices, signed quality agreements with the majority of our manufacturing partners. Yeah, and based on these quality agreements, we are audited periodically by our partners.
Okay.
So our quality management system is checked periodically, several times in a year, by different partners and validated to be according to ISO 13485, to MDR, to good distribution practices, and to some other internal standards that manufacturers have.
So it's good for your manufacturers that you are ISO 13485, because then, you know, sometimes you have those supplier evaluation, supplier approval, and they're asking you, can you show me that you are certified? Can you show me this? Can you show me that? So many the idea was this. I mean, even me, they ask me when they ask me, are you ISO certified? I mean, I say, no, I have a quality management system, but I'm not ISO certified because I don't need specifically. But yeah, the idea is that to evaluate your suppliers, you have to ask him questions. Are you this? Are you that? Do you have this? Do you have that? Et cetera, et cetera. So this is the normal process. And I suppose that for you, by being ISO 13485, it is really, if I can say, helpful for your customers also.
Yes, indeed, it is helpful and also challenging in the same time. And sometimes we notice some customer requirements, for example, in tenders for an ISO 13485 certificate in order to participate in public tenders. From time to time, we started to notice such requirements. In our region, in our five countries where Sofmedica is operating, Romania, Bulgaria, Greece, Cyprus, and Hungary. So not in all these countries.
But it means that it's an advantage for you when there is a tender that you are ISO 13485. If your competitor to the tender is not, you can win the tender because of that.
So far, we didn't face practically such such situations, but we really hope so to be the case in the future, because really we prefer such kind of competition based on loyal principles than competitors with unloyal principles. So I think ISO 13485 can be a real sustainable competitive advantage.
Exactly. And did you had any impact of MDR to this certification or to the objective of the certification here?
Yes, as I mentioned, when we started our preparation for MDR, we noticed in 2017 that MDR has been published and this is the law, and we started to learn. We started to learn individually initially, and then we did external trainings like Green Belt, and then we did in-house trainings in order to create internally awareness and, moreover, awareness of top management, because this is very important to all the team members in an organization to be aware of the requirements. And when we after this learning, we did a gap analysis during one internal audit, and following this gap analysis, we established an action plan with very clear responsibles and timelines in order to update our system, create new procedures, create new templates, forms, update our ERP system, implement a document management system in order to comply with MDR. And if I may say, the ISO 13485 certification was more a consequence of all this preparation work for our MDR compliance.
So one of the elements of Article 16 and also of one guidance is the MDCG 2021-23 about Article 16.4 regarding translation and repackaging of products. So this was also mentioned that it should be specific for certain type of products. So were you certified for every product or just a certain type of products?
Our scope of ISO 13485 certificate is specific for certain devices. For example, active surgical devices used in robotic assisted surgery, surgical care, cardiovascular care, endoscopy, and critical care. Of course, all the related services starting with distribution, installation, servicing, distribution of related spare parts, provision, including translation of the information supplied by manufacturer, clinical support and training for related medical devices of professional users.
So let's say that tomorrow you have another customer that comes to you that is not on scope of this ISO 13485. So, because as we said, you are an importer distributor, so you have multiple customers that are coming to you to help them to import and distribute the products in Europe. So the point is that if tomorrow you have a new customer and the scope is outside of your ISO, how is it working then?
In this case, we will have to apply change management. So first, we have created a change management process. We are doing an impact assessment with SWOT analysis and an action plan to prepare the grounds in order to accept or not the new customer and the new business. And then if the analysis is positive, we will have to implement the same rules and procedures for the new business line and go through an extension of our scope of certification, most probably with the occasion of the next surveillance audit.
Okay. And now that you are certified, so if I can say, so can you tell us more about this journey? So was it an easy journey that you recommend to everybody, or were there some difficulties that you can maybe share with us to say, oh, be careful of this or be careful of that?
Oh, definitely. And I can talk for hours or days about this journey and the challenges because really I enjoyed a lot. And not only me, the entire team, quality and compliance team, and I can say that the entire Sofmedica team. So we faced many challenges during our journey. And I will try to list them very fast and then elaborate a bit.
Yeah.
So the most important or the first on the list could be the limited capacity of notified body.
Okay.
The integration of ISO 13485 requirements into our group quality management system, ISO 9001 certified, knowing that 13485 is superseded by 9001 latest edition. Or another challenge, preparation for MDR was the documents management system, a digital tool. And maybe the last and the most important challenge was to update our ERP, our informatic system, in order to integrate the updates and do some automatization.
Okay.
So, speaking about the limited capacity of notified body, as we all know, usually a manufacturer has to wait 1 year for their audit.
Yeah.
In order to pursue our ISO 13485 certification, we have contacted 56 notified body, really, okay, literally, in 2020. In the middle of pandemic, in our effort to find an MDR notified body capable to certify our quality management system. Some of them replied they have limited capacity and denied the request. Some others send offers. We succeeded to select a notified body that replied they are waiting for to be designated under MDR in NANDO system. Okay. After 6 months of waiting, we realized that they will not make it, and we restarted our selection. Speaking about suppliers' control and selection of the supplier.
Yeah.
Finally, we succeeded to contract one notified body designated under MDR, and in November 2020, we have been successfully passed the audit, the certification audit planned several months ahead. And we received the certification after the certificate after some other months in April 2020.
Oh, so November the audit?
Yes.
Then November April, the certificate. Wow, indeed. It's like a 6 month period. Wow.
I need to mention this audit was a premiere also for our notified body, as they as the auditor told us during the audit, as they usually certify medical device manufacturers. So this is this was something very new also for them.
Yeah. It's what we said also. We said that now the scope of notified bodies increased. Before, they had manufacturers only. Then they got the Annex 16 products with aesthetic purposes.
Yes.
And now they get also with Article 16 importer distributors that are with medical devices. So their scope is really increasing. So yes, there is a lot of premieres for also those notified bodies that never had to do that before, but now they have to do that. So it's really, really important to mention. But yeah, there is apparently a long time to reserve your certificate. So don't think that because you are certified, because the audit was passed and successfully passed, that you are certified. You are certified when you reserve your certificate. So don't think that, oh, because you passed the audit maybe in May 2024, that it's fine, everything is fine. No, you reserve maybe your certificate in January 2025.
Very true.
So then you cannot sell your products during that time because you have to wait 2025 for that. So be careful of also this kind of timing.
Very true. And another challenge, as I mentioned, in our MDR readiness was the documents management system. We realized in 2017 that we need such a tool, such a digital tool to manage the document, the QMS documentation, and not only, all the documents of the company. Thus, in 2020, we finalized the selection of a provider and we started the implementation of a documents management system software with the analysis phase.
Okay.
But unfortunately, later on, the provider selected and contracted notified us that they are out of capacity due to COVID pandemic.
Oh.
Something which nobody...
Yeah, can you
understood. Imagine, exactly. Yes, before. So we started again the market research and the selection process. We contracted another provider, and now we are in the process of implementing, finalized. We have finalized the analysis stage. Now we are during the configuration stage.
So okay.
We are much more advanced now. And the last, the biggest challenge was the updating of our ERP system.
Okay.
Because we had to add additional fields to create in the system in order to automatically record UDI codes directly in the system using a reader mobile device. Today, our ERP system is extracting from the UDI codes the appropriate data. Code, batch number, or serial number, expiry date, manufacturing date, and placing in the dedicated fields of ERP. This is a fantastic job and a real hard work that we did last year.
Yeah, it's what we are also training people during the Green Belt, because we are explaining about the UDI, the UDI-DI and the UDI-PI. And if you have a software that is really well configured, just by scanning, you don't have to write anymore the expiration data. And just by scanning, you can see if the product is already expired or not when you have to ship it out or this and that. So it's actually something that's really helpful.
Actually, we did a video last year describing our supply and distribution processes and how we have been implemented MDR requirements, MDR obligations for distributor and important. And we can provide to you this link.
Yeah, so let's provide the link and put that on the show notes so that people can get that also.
Also, speaking about ERP updates, a document, we created a document in this ERP which is printed together with the invoice and delivery note with the purpose to help the warehouse operator to add various documents to a shipment.
Okay.
Or label, for example, EU importer label for the devices where Sofmedica is an importer, because
exactly,
we are not an importer for all the devices, which makes the things a bit more complicated, or adding the safety data sheet in the local language, or IFU translated in the local language, or the document indicating that Sofmedica has translated this document. So we have automated this, and our video will explain
so great,
all of this.
I'm really happy that you are using those methodologies, because it's mainly something that is really important, that finding a way to automatize everything, to make everything that is working, that you don't need a lot of effort from your team to comply to those rules, because you have the right tool in place to help you to put the right label at the right place, to extract the right information, which is exactly what is why it is really important here.
And moreover, this is a systematic approach, because, okay, we have one people or two people very well trained. They will do the job perfectly. But if they will change, if they will take holiday, we need a systematic approach. So we need the system to say to the operator what documents to add to a shipment and how the label should be placed.
Great. I mean, just by hearing you, I say, oh, I'm really confident of working with you for any of my products. I know the products that I would have then, because as I've said, yeah, having the right tools that are validated, that are helping, and that are not dependent on people that are here or not here or sick or whatever, is really important for safety and performance of your device. And that it's really, I think, a good sign of quality. Is there
we
any other?
We can call it good practice or best practice, how our manufacturing partners already mentioned during the audits they do. For example, our reception process is really a good practice. And you can see this in the video. We have implemented also a sampling algorithm based on MDR, according to MDR requirements. So, for example, if we receive one pallet of goods, same code, same batch, we are checking a certain, for example, one box.
Okay.
But if we are receiving several batches, we have a specific algorithm to check them. Of course, we are checking all class 3 implantable medical devices.
So sampling,
because of the risk. Based on the risk.
Yeah, so sampling is mentioned on the article 14-15 of the regulation, where it's talking about the responsibility of distributors and importers. So yeah, it's I think something that is really, really important for you to do. Is there any other elements, any other things that you were about to say?
Oh, yes, there are many. Everyone who is considered an economic operator, like suppliers, distributors, importers, must understand the changes brought by MDR and have a plan in place for compliance. And I can say that ISO 13485 contributes to achieve this compliance, contributes to improve reputation of the company. So they improve overall overall performance. They offer a systematic, it offers a systematic approach for risk management, For example, we had to update our risk management process with descriptors for safety and performance of medical devices and to run these exercises periodically. And I can say that organizations involved in any phase of medical devices life cycle, in order to demonstrate their compliance with mandatory requirements like MDR and in order to implement good practices, they should have a quality management system in place, ISO 13485. We strongly believe that our quality management system has a significant contribution to our sustainable business growth. And currently, quality and compliance are two important pillars of our sustainable development. And we would like to encourage as many economic operators as possible to invest in such quality management system and implement any ECG standards, as this show commitment, consistency, and this could contribute to placing on the market safe and performant medical devices. And moreover, consolidate the reputation of the industry and maybe could contribute to the elimination of the companies which are not serious and interested only for profit.
Exactly. I mean, you have companies that are, as you said, interested for profits that are maybe going up, but then going down because they have a big issue, then going up again, going down. But here we are more in a smooth curve that we are really investing times, consolidating, and then growing, investing time, consolidating, growing, etc., which helps you to get better. There are always issues, but as you have a quality management system, if you use it correctly, the issues will be absorbed, easily managed, and then you have find the right solution to correct it and then move forward. So if you are using correctly your quality management system, then it's like that. If you are just using quality management system as a documentation to be able to get a certificate, it will not work at all, because I mean, I saw a lot of companies doing that and it's not really working at all. So so Cristina, can you tell me more than maybe about Sofmedica? So what people can be, why people should be calling you for calling Sofmedica? So what would be their interest to call Sofmedica?
Has been founded in 1994. Open and create new pathways for medical systems in the region. Sofmedica was founded in 1994 in Romania first. And now we are present, as I mentioned, in four countries. We have offices in Romania, Greece, Bulgaria, Cyprus, and Hungary. And we are the most innovative medical technology and laparoscopic surgery, diagnostic and treatment in the field of gastroenterology, diagnosis and treatment in intensive care, pulmo care. So we are investing a lot in education of healthcare professionals and in education of our people. We realized early on that we as a business have a real contribution to the society, because we don't only contribute by paying taxes, by employing people, and by investing in the region. We are also doing training and education for the employees, for the healthcare professionals, and the last but not the least, through setting good practices for other economic operator. And more recently, we realized that we have been driven by long-term investment always. And recently, we realized that environmental sustainability, which initially was a collateral benefit, has become a strategic objective for us now. And we have just succeeded to finalize the integration of 14,001 requirements into our group management system. And now we are committed to systematically manage the environmental aspects right, in order to continue to operate in a safe workplace and healthy environment for all the stakeholders. And for the first in the first place for the patients, which are the end users of our technology.
Great. So really happy that you are thinking like that, and that your company is also going in that direction, because it's really important, as you said, that we think about the person that will be using our products. As I've said, when I'm working, if there is a difficult situation, the thing is that would I give these products to a member of my family? If the answer is no, so then you are doing something wrong. So you have to stop here. So this is mainly the idea, and I'm really happy that companies are really also having that in mind, and not only for quality regulatory, but also sustainability and environmental control, everything. So it's really something that is great. So as you said, I will place all the links for Sofmedica Group and videos, maybe for people to know more about you and that they can go and visit you. And really thank you for sharing with us the experience you had about ISO 13485, about certification. As I said, it's really important that also importers and distributors are also getting that in mind, because they are part of the supply chain, they are part of the distribution of the products. So if they are not done correctly, even if the product is good at the beginning, if they arrive to a distributor that is not really doing good his job, so then it will maybe fail when it will arrive there. So really great. Thank you for that. Okay, so if people are listening to this video, so thank you. If you have any question also to Cristina or Sofmedica, as I said, I will put all the links on the show notes. If you want to contact them so that they can work with you also, it will be really a pleasure, I suppose, for them. And if you like also what we are doing on Easy Medical Device, so don't hesitate to go to the YouTube channel and just place a comment or a like also, just to say that you like what you are seeing. And if you have any question, don't hesitate to send me a message at info@easymedicaldevice.com. Okay, Cristina, it was really a pleasure to have you, and I wish you a nice day.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.